All right, we are live. Happy Sunday, everyone, and we are back with our new episode, another episode of EU-based Unstoppable Pinay Digital Entrepreneur, together with my business partners. But tonight, my business partner Christine from Norway, and one of our business partners can't be with us. So, hi, Dean. How are you?
Hi, Michelle. I'm doing good. And Happy New Year to everyone. I think the last time that we were with each other, bago mag-New Year pa. So, yeah, Happy New Year. And yeah, another year for me as well. It was my birthday last Wednesday.
Happy birthday!
Thank you.
So, you have a great birthday, Tina. I saw that. You have a beautiful
birthday. Yeah, getting young again. More. more numbers adding up, but getting wisdom, I hope.
Yeah, you know, I remember that every New Year, someone was crying because I thought, I have a friend. He was crying after a New Year. I said, why are you crying? It's New Year. You don't need to cry. He said, you know why? Because New Year means we have added another year. So we're getting older.
Yeah. Just look on the positive side.
So here in our another episode, before we are going to share something, because we there's so many of you who are in our pages or in Christine pages, we always have that question that people always ask if they need. I think I need to share that. Do you have any prior knowledge or are you a tech savvy in starting a business? So we love to answer that because everyone, I think, would love to know what if you need experience when you go inside this business. But a short introduction for us, for me. I am Michelle and Sitintin, Christine. We are from Filipino. So, Filipina po kami na dito kami na based sa Europe. So, me, I am from Spain and Christine from Belgium, Norway, sorry. And our other business partner from Belgium. So, in this episode, we would love to share to everyone kung paano kami nagsimula, kung hindi lang sa episode na to, from the very beginning of our episode, sinabi namin kung paano kami nagsimula, kung paano kami nag-start ng business. At like me, actually I didn't know Tintin personally, but we met here and we start to share live to everyone kasi gusto din namin makatulong sa kapwa nating Pilipino na siguro matagal-tagal na rin kayo pag nasa ibang bansa kayo, di ba? Like me, I am here in Spain for more than 14 years. I just have celebrate my anniversary 10 days ago. So 15 years. So nag-iisip kayo, bakit kailangan natin mag ibang bansa for so many years, right? So we are here inside this business. So I've been in the business for 31 months. Nandito na ako. So, like Christine, how many months you are here, Tin?
It's gonna be my anniversary next month, February. Oh. I started. Yay! I started actually the 17th of February,
wow.
2023.
And you're still
so here. I'm on my way to my 1 year anniversary.
Wow, congratulations, Tin. And imagine that, nandito ka for 1 year na. Ako nga, more than 2 years na. So, meaning to say, mayroon talagang nabibigay yung business. So, would you like to a little introduction, Tin?
Yeah, my name is Christine. For the people who just followed my page recently, especially last November, December, because we are quite busy and a lot of new followers came. So my name is Christine. I'm a mom to my two beautiful daughters. One is 5 years old and one is 2 years old. And I am a healthcare professional here in Norway. I am a nurse back in the Philippines. I'm a registered nurse. And I'm working in the biggest rehabilitation hospital here in Norway, dealing with spinal cord injury patients. So, wow. And I've been into the business for almost a year. In 2 weeks' time or 3 weeks' time, I will be 1 year. It's going to be my first anniversary in as a digital business owner. So I am grateful and happy that, you know, the first year, it's really in every kind of business, traditional business, digital business, the first year or first 2 years of the business, that's going to be the you're building your business, the foundation of your business. So that particular year, it's very crucial. It's not easy. It's not simple. It's really a struggle. It's miss or break, but you have to be tough. And if you know your why, if you focus on your why, so the business will be going on and andyan ka na eh. So you just have to, you know, you just have to grab, even though na sometimes it's hard, you know, it's not going to be easy as always because you're still building your foundation. Kahit naman if you're building a home, di ba? If you're building a building, so yung foundation, yun ang pinakamatagal kasi yun ang pinaka dapat na matibay at mahirap. So it's the same here as what I've experienced, but you know, I am lucky enough because we do have this community all over the world with more than 150,000 people worldwide that is pushing you up and helping you with this business. It doesn't matter if you are connected financially or the same country or the same ethnicity, but we are all helping each other. And I'm very grateful for that one.
Yeah, me too. Me too. So one of our questions is about, do you have any prior knowledge or are you tech savvy before starting your online business? If no, how did you manage? So that's actually a question.
Yeah, for me, I'm really not a tech savvy. You witness it. Even the camera before we went live, I don't have the camera. I have to call my husband downstairs taking care of the kids. I'm really not a tech savvy. All I know is holding my phone and, you know, just the usual people just looking and browsing on your social media, like, for a spare time or something like that. But as a tech savvy, no, I'm not. I'm not a tech savvy. I'm a nurse by profession. I deal with patients like physically and emotionally. So I don't have that strength to, you know, to have like, you know, the mind of the IT or the mind of the people with, you know, computer background. No, I'm not that one. And I don't have any background with the business itself or with any kind of business. I do want to be a business business-oriented person because there's more opportunity if you have your own business, but I don't have any background at all. My dad, he used to have his own company, a telecommunication company back in the Philippines, but I don't enter or I don't deal with any transaction with his business because I'm still young during the time that when he had a company. So nothing at all. This is, I started from scratch. I deal with the people in the community. I learn, I do the training, and I'm still learning up to this point.
Well, contrary to yours, mine, when I was graduated as computer education, so I have a little bit knowledge. But you know that you graduated like 10 years or 15 years ago before I found the business again, and you can't remember everything what's going on with programming or anything about it, right? But when I started a business, I saw a little bit easier for me, right? Easier to follow. like Tintin mentioned, I know a lot of coaches in our community. They are not the tech savvy, and they started the business from scratch, and they did it very well. Because, you know, I guess there is a proper training, a video-based proper training for everyone who are not experienced enough to start your own online business, and they guided you. And besides, with the support of the community, there's also a mentor and a coach, right? That always there. If you need some question, if you need some help, then you can ask them some help. So that is the beauty of this business, the help of and support of our community members. And also, it's easy to manage, right, Tin? Because
yes,
you, I guess Tintin is a full-time nurse.
Yeah.
So me, I didn't, when I stopped my job way back 2 years ago, and I saw this business and the potential of the business, so I decided I need to stay focused on the business and stay full-time. But actually, I don't recommend to everyone to start a business that immediately you go full-time. Because there's a saying that if you wanted to become successful, this is a business. So in order for you to grow, you need to feed your business, right? Because if you're feeding your business, meaning to say that business will feed you one day or years later. So for me, I guess that's one of my error, that I started full-time right away. I didn't think about that I need to feed my business. So what happened now, I balance my time together with the business and other things that I can do and to provide my business. And it's easy because time management has also been teaching in our community. So we have webinar. You can learn from other people here, their experience, and they share their knowledge on how they manage their time, how they can handle between family, job, and the business. So it's pretty, like, you're so much encouraging and inspired to be like them, right? So nung nag-English na tayo, so nag-start kami, we just started with that, and nag-umpisa din ako ng focus dito sa business. But actually, I need to be fit this business. And then, I realized that it's pretty easy to handle. But you need, like Tintin mentioned, it's not an easy, quick-rich business. Kailangan mo magtrabaho. Kasi kailangan mo mag-umunlad yung buhay mo. Kaya kailangan mo mag-work. Kasi makikita mo talaga dito sa business na to. Honestly, maraming Pilipino, OFW, or Pilipinong nagtatrabaho sa ibang bansa like Canada, USA, Australia, nandito sila sa business at naging successful ang buhay nila. Sinabi ko nga sa sarili ko, sana noon ko pa nakita yung business na to. Kasi malaki ang may tutulong niya sa akin, lalo sa family ko back home. Kasi ako ay breadwinner din ng family. So, eldest child ng family. So, alam mo na yun. So, mga kapwa-Pilipino na nanonood, kung eldest child ka, marami kang sinusuportahan. Ano, ganon. So, focus sa business, focus ka din sa family mo back home. Magandang idea ang digital business. So, nire-recommend ko po ito sa lahat na OFW or Pilipino na nagtatrabaho dyan sa iba't ibang dito sa Europe or wherever part of the world you are, kasi nagsastruggle ka, you may start. Basta may internet connection ka lang at may phone ka at may computer, you can start this business wherever you are without prior knowledge or tech savvy. Anything to add, then? I guess, anything to add, then? I'm not sure you can hear me. I lose your signal. So I didn't hear Tintin now. I guess he loses his internet connection. Imagine that. She's living in Norway. And sometimes we have problem when we started our live. May problema kami sa mga connection. Pero imagine that even though that we are struggling, we get together na makumpal namin yung aming time dito para magbibigay lang ng magandang recommend sa mga kapwa Pilipino. Do you hear me, Tin? Oh, I didn't hear her. Maybe she's frozen. I didn't hear her.
No, you're having a connection problem.
I was not your frozen.
Michelle.
Yeah, you have got the connection problem. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think we're having a system glitch right now, but that's how it is. The business is still have to go on. But yeah, we will be inviting you. If you are interested, you can tap on us, you can message us, or you can say a comment on just how, and then we will be helping you. We will be walking you through to the business, and you can watch our webinar. We do have a replay, and we do have a live webinar every Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Yeah,
we'll see you inside.
Yeah, we hope to see you inside, and we are here to help you. So that's all our episode for today, and see you again in the next episode next week, and hope Percy can come with us also. So thank you, Tin. See you next week.
Yeah.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you, Michelle. See you. Happy New Year. Bye-bye.
Bye.